But now even allies voicing their concerns.
It is equally important to ensure that those who identify the problem must necessarily work towards providing an expeditious solution as well.
Possibly a message that Pawar needs to get cracking on solutions rather than outlining the problems. With Navika Kumar in New Delhi, Dipankar Paul, Times Now.
We are being told here at Times Now by sources in the Ministry of External Affairs that if there is another race attack, India could issue a second advisory, and this time warning travellers as well as students from Indians going to Australia. Foul play has been ruled out in the chopper crash that killed YSR Reddy. The four-member inquiry committee into the incident that led to the death of Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister YSR Reddy has said the crash was caused by pilot error. The Maharashtra government has been nudged into action after Times Now highlighted the plight of 14-year-old Chiranjeev Shah, who is suffering from liver cirrhosis but is unable to get a liver transplant because of red tape. Maharashtra Health Minister Suresh Shetty has directed his officers to take charge of the child's treatment. The UN's Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change has admitted its mistake by asserting that Himalayan glaciers that could disappear by 2035. They have now clarified that. They said it was an error that they included this date in climate impact assessments. Local court in Hyderabad has extended the judicial remand of all the 10 accused in the multi-crore Satyam scam, including Ramalingam Raju, till the 3rd of February. So the case is just dragging on. Indian opener Gautam Gambhir has become the fourth batsman to score a century in 5 consecutive test matches. Gambhir joined an elite list of batsmen who have achieved the feat, joining the likes of Don Bradman, Jacques Callis and Mohammad Yusuf.
5 out of 5 in consecutive matches.
They are being called the spy cam wars. Himachal Pradesh former chief minister armed with what he claims is proof against the current chief minister. The supposed proof, CDs. Interestingly, this accusation coming 5 months after Mr. Veerbhadra Singh himself was tainted by charges using a CD against him.
Himachal politics, what is being hit interestingly by being called a CD spy cam, was a chief minister versus a former chief minister. Interestingly, what both have against each other are mere CDs.
On the two sides are these two men. One who is the current Chief Minister P.K. Dhumal. The other side, the man making the accusations, former Chief Minister Veerbhadra Singh.
Well, I've always maintained Mr. Dhumal has chosen a wrong profession. He shouldn't have been a politician, he should have been a spy.
The proof, an audio CD in which the chief minister is allegedly talking to a high-ranking police official, also suggesting the former chief minister's phone be tapped.
CD or audio cassette recording or the other bharenge.
जी बताइए जी की फोन टैपिंग
इसको करना है.
हाँ जी करना है.
आज मुख्यमंत्री मैंने 25 करोड़ खाया है. 3 लाख ले लो.
ठीक है जी.
जब ज्यादा कमाएंगे ज्यादा आएगा तो ज्यादा पाएंगे.
Dhumal says that it is nothing but a conspiracy.
We have got certain informations. There are number of CDs. There is not only these 3 CDs. Such fabricated CDs have been prepared in large number and they are expected to be released from time to time.
The former chief minister has now given more proof. A video CD in which a key member of the Dhumal camp, Virendra Kashyap, is allegedly showing accepting cash, a charge that he vehemently denies.
जहाँ तक contents मुझे पता लग रहा है, that is totally fake and fabricated. ये मामला उस वक्त जो मैं कह रहा हूँ, उस वक्त आया था, अखबारों में भी बात उस वक्त काफी उछली थी, पर ये मेरे राजनीतिक विरोधी और कुछ व्यक्तिगत विरोधी हो सकते हैं.
Interestingly, not too long back, the roles were completely reversed and it was the accused who was actually the accuser.
Mr. Dhumal does not believe in niceties of relationships. Let him do what he wants to do. I don't care about it. And ultimately, truth shall triumph. And I will come out unscathed.
Politicians have conducted sting operations on their rivals in the past. While we are not verifying the authenticity of these CDs, one thing is certain, that this CD war in Himachal Pradesh is a new low in politics.
With Jabaki in Shimla and Nandita in Delhi, this is Harishri for Times Now.
And the same politicians tell journalists don't do sting operations, however noble the cause. In this case, the pot's calling the kettle black, and it appears all pots and kettles are black as of now. Reminder that we have a big debate coming up just 2 minutes from now. What's his justification for having language rules for cab drivers? Wasn't this man, Chief Minister of Maharashtra Ashok Chavan, at the forefront of all the criticism of what Raj Thackeray was doing till recently? That's our story. You need to know Marathi to be a cabby driver in Maharashtra. That's part of a new set of rules by the Maharashtra government, the Congress NCP government. Opposition claims this is competitive regional politics.
This is the one symbol Mumbai is best known for, the black and yellow Fiat taxis snaking their way through the city. The taxis driven mostly by industrious migrants who have made the metropolis their home. Now the government has brought a new law for these drivers. To get a license, they need to live in the state for 15 years and know how to read and write Marathi. Achhi taxis
air-conditioned aur puri adhik suvidha ho sakti hai. Usme radio call center ho sakta hai. मोबाइल के जरिए उनको कॉल करके बुलाया जा सकता और जो भी ड्राइवर उसमें एम्प्लॉय हो जाएंगे मराठी जान सके पढ़ सके लिख सके ऐसे ड्राइवर्स उन्हें एम्प्लॉय करने चाहिए.
The government's move is seen as being more about politics than anything else. A pro Marathi stance to take on the ever aggressive Sena and MNS.
These conditions are not acceptable to us. See, this is total injustice on the taxi man.
जरूरी कदम उठाया है जो बहुत पहले उठाना चाहिए था. हम 20 साल से इस बारे में बोल रहे हैं, उससे पहले भी बात कर रहे हैं.
It's 100% wrong. I'm telling you, this is unconstitutional.
For the drivers, this could very well spell doom. Several young men come to Mumbai and take up the profession in the hope of spinning a rags to riches story.
Marathi हमको आती नहीं उतनी, तो इसलिए सरकार जो नियम लगा रही है वो बिल्कुल गलत है.
अगर कोई जरूरी नहीं है मराठी आना, तो हिंदी चलता है, कोई हिंदी सब जालू जाते हैं, सबको हिंदी आता है.
It's the end of the road for these taxis as Mumbai looks to go the Shanghai way. And with the government's new move, perhaps for these drivers too. Bureau Report, Times Now.
On the show this evening, Abhishek Manu Singhvi is with us. Rahul Nardekar of the Shiv Sena is with us. Dr. Mona Shah of the Professionals Party of India is with us. Dr. Singhvi, to you first. I mean, this was Raj Thackeray's campaign. Now, Raj Thackeray is not the chief minister. Ashok Chavan of the Congress Party is the chief minister. In a democracy, language cannot be the basis of preference, especially for taxi drivers.
Arnab, I entirely agree with you. The way you put it simply, that if there was a new rule created saying that they should pass some kind of a test and trying to disqualify and keep out people, I would myself be opposing it. But just note quickly, God lies in the details, the devil also lies in the details. This is a 1989 rule. It's a typical rule in a central act called the Motor Vehicles Act, which has state-made rules in different states. So Odisha and West Bengal, for all you know, would have similar rules for their own language.
No, no, one second.
This is not a formal test.
No, no, why
it's
now?
It's not as if I have to come as a cabbie and take a test.
So why now?
It has not led to exclusion of cab drivers for the last 20 years.
So
resolution did not... Just one second, let me complete, Arna, please. The cabinet did not amend this rule, did not make a new rule. They simply passed a resolution saying that there is a rule, that rule should be enforced for the new fleet of 24,000 taxis which are coming up in phases.
No.
So don't think it's going to lead to en masse exclusions. No. There is no formal test. It's just a form. It's a kind of a geographical thing.
If
you are working cabs in a particular area,
you use the right word.
The broad locality and the language.
No, Dr. Singhvi, you use the right word. I didn't. You use the word exclusive. Exclusivist policy. This is in a sense an exclusivist policy. And yes, you are right. God is in the details, because the details will tell you, Dr. Singhvi, that proportion of migrants to Mumbai from within Maharashtra is highest at 37%. You would also know. Then what about the rest of the 50% in Maharashtra who don't speak Marathi? You know, the principle in a sense is exclusivist. I want to get another point of view in, Dr. Monasha. Let me get your point of view.
The point of view is very simple. We talk about discrimination against our people in foreign countries. This is completely discriminatory within our own country. There is nothing in this which shows us working towards national integration. In fact, this is just divisive. It's just politics. And at the end of it, I don't know who really benefits at the end of it.
Okay. Rahul Darwekar, who is here from the Shiv Sena, claims that this is actually the Shiv Sena's victory. I just want to get your point of view, and Rahul, directly to what Dr. Singhvi said.
Well, there's no question of victory. This is a victory for the people of Maharashtra and the people of Mumbai. Please appreciate, this is a demand of Shiv Sena for the last 20 years. Though being a legitimate demand, the government has not implemented it till date. The timing of implementing this policy now, which was decided way back in 1989, is pretty surprising. Rather late than never. Wisdom has prevailed over this government, and they've decided to implement this
policy.
Rahul,
you are into, you are taking political credit.
For Marathi people and Maharashtrians.
Rahul, you are taking political credit.
The Congress will have to explain the timing of this decision.
You are taking political credit, Rahul. Here we are talking about whether this is right, Dr. Singhvi, whether it is right for a large number of taxi drivers in Mumbai who come from UP and Bihar.
Credit.
You are saying UP and Bihar taxi drivers can't come to Mumbai.
For this.
Arnav, can I reply?
Question. Yes, go ahead. Dr. Singhvi, go ahead. I'll come to you.
This was our demand. The government did not agree to it for the last so many years.
Arnav,
finally, they have, good sense has prevailed over the government. They have decided to implement this policy. That being the case, I definitely take this as a victory of the efforts of Shiv Sena and the efforts of the people of Mumbai, Maharashtra.
I asked Abhishek Singhvi a question. Dr. Singhvi, my question to you is, will you support today if Narendra Modi says that you have to A, know Gujarati, B, have lived in Ahmedabad for 15 years to be a taxi driver, say if there are taxis in Ahmedabad, and if this same policy is applied to Srinagar, Chandigarh, Guwahati, that to be Bangalore, I mean, won't this really hurt the cosmopolitan character of our cities, Dr. Singh?
Let's put things in perspective. I think you are enlarging the issue far beyond what it is actually happening. First of all, there's no question of victory or defeat. We are the only party which has stood up very categorically to the Shiv Sena rhetoric, the Shiv Sena chauvinism. This is simply a continuation by reiterating a 1989 rule. This rule has not been challenged for the last 20 years. It has been the law of Maharashtra. And
sir,
if you check up the Motor Vehicles Act, you will find similar state rules. Just let me complete one second. You will find similar rules in several states.
Mr. Singhvi, why wasn't it implemented?
But more important,
it's a rule
in the practical operation,
1989. Why has it not been implemented till date?
No, Mike, that's not the question.
No.
The Shops and Establishments Act requires
that every shop
shall have Devanagari script.
No, one second. Rahul, let's be very clear about one thing.
When Shiv Sena decided to implement that, why did the Congress party heavily come down on the Sena? Rahul, that's not the question.
Question is, Dr. Singhvi, I'm staying on with, I'm coming to you, Mona. Question is, in this country, as Dr. Singhvi, as an eminent jurist, knows, there are laws that date back 150 years which deserve to be changed. Question is, why does the Congress Chief Minister of Maharashtra want to change the rule for taxi drivers
only
having to be local domiciled, something which was principally Raj Thackeray's campaign?
At the cost of repetition, Arnab, there is not a comma full stop change in the law. There is no amendment, no repeal, no new law. And 1989 rule has simply been remembered and reiterated by a cabinet resolution. Let me tell you that who says
now
the law has not been enforced. Just let me complete now. The law has been enforced from 89.
Yeah.
What we are saying is that in the operational reality of that law, nobody has been really excluded, because it requires all these people to fill up a form. They don't have to go and sit for a test. 20. No Bihari or Uttar Pradesh migrant has been excluded.
Okay, but Mona, very briefly.
You already have the taxi union saying that they're completely not in agreement with this kind of a law and they're going to challenge it. So you're going to be burdening an already overburdened judiciary, and every time this is the state of affairs that keeps going on, and eventually it's a perception that is created that the politics is actually going to help the common man when you're actually hitting one common man against another. You're playing divisive politics, you're creating perceptions simply to garner these vote banks, and at the end of the day, no common man is benefited.
Dr. Singhvi, can you hold your heart and say, Dr. Singhvi, that you would feel any less comfortable if the taxi driver who was driving you in Mumbai, the next time you're in Mumbai, say, hadn't lived in Mumbai for 15 years and didn't know Marathi?
I'll tell you. Just look at it reasonably. The idea, what is the rationale behind this? Now, remember two things. The constitution is higher than a statute is higher than a rule. Anybody could have challenged this for last 20 years and have it struck down. Nobody has. Okay. It has stood the test of time. If as she says it is now challenged, it will be set aside. It will be set aside.
That's,
so be it. But today Singhvi, stands as the law. Doctor, if I am driving, yes, 1 minute, let me answer your question. Yeah. Arnab, your second question, the idea, the rationale is that when you are driving a taxi, you should have familiarity with the local neighborhood.
Why has that been realized tonight?
That's about it.
Why is that?
Nothing much more than
that. Why is it? No. My question is very basic. I know that you are arguing on the hard line of the law. I am asking a more basic question, not a legal question. Did Ashok Chauhan get up this morning and suddenly realize
that
if you don't know Marathi, you can't drive a taxi? And has he suddenly realized that there is a 15-year-old law? And has he therefore suddenly gone out and made this comment? No, Dr. Singhvi, your smile is giving you away. I'm glad you've smiled, but I must appreciate that legally you've fought this case extremely hard and well. I'm going to wrap it up. Dr. Singhvi, you'll go around in circles and you'll drive me around legal circles. I will not be driven around legal circles by you, Dr. Singhvi. But you have a point
I'm
there.
I'm only saying you have to put that last question. You have to put the last question to Mr. Ashok Chauhan.
Okay, as all good spokespersons say, at the point, put the question to the Chief Minister, let him answer. He knows it's a tough question. Simple but tough question. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining me on that debate. We're coming back in 2 minutes with another hard debate. Who's right? Who's wrong? Now, this climate change controversy is spinning out of control. Who's doing a U-turn? Who's denied the 2035 theory? Back with that one.